Hello everybody, welcome back to another video. I'm hoping you guys are all having a fantastic day. So I decided to make a quick little video today regarding the potential for a fairly rare occurrence of frost, across Minnesota, North Dakota. This definitely does happen and has happened before. It's just that it's still very interesting to see that we're having an outbreak of tornadoes and severe weather associated with the warm weather to the south, and up to the north we're seeing frost and freeze warnings. If we go to South Dakota, or northwestern South Dakota, we see freeze warnings, which basically means it could drop down below 30 degrees, maybe even to like the upper 20s in these parts of these areas, which is very chilly, and again, sensitive areas will possibly get frozen over. So, I mean, it's, almost summer, May 19th today, but, still, frost and freezes are occurring. I'd quickly like to remind you guys, if you want to subscribe to this channel, you could do so. I will be uploading more of these videos throughout summer and fall. As you can see, let's just go to Aberdeen, since that is like the office, forecast office. You can see they have a frost advisory and a freeze warning, and it's from tonight into Monday. But look, I mean, otherwise from that, they go into the 60s. They go from frost into the 60s, which is very warm, and almost a 30 degree temperature change, which is very substantial. This is what you'll get in a in a springtime, or almost late spring, almost summer. You'll see, if you do even see, you'll see that you go from a really cold low to a high of 60. Let's go to an area. I want to show you an area like Denver. Okay, so they don't have any freeze warnings or freeze watches, but I still want to go and click on Denver and show you some of these contrasts that they have. So you can see during the nights it's 42, during the days, this isn't as showing as big of a contrast. Right there's the day, 36, 64. Sometimes Denver could, fluctuate almost like 80 degrees. One time it went from 80 degrees to, not 80, but like 70, 60 for sure. One time it went from 80 degrees to 20 degrees, and it was a snowstorm the next day. I remember that was 2 years ago, and that was associated with Winter Storm Aiden. It was a very early system. But if we go to, say, a city like Minneapolis, it's a large city. You could see they're gonna be cold leading to frost tonight. There's a frost advisory, and you could see 44 for Sunday, which is today, so very chilly, and it will be ending the rain. But again, the frost, look at that, look at these predicted highs, 29, 27, that's almost a freeze warning criteria, I would actually say. But they have not decided to issue one, and look at that, that's just ridiculous, 23, 25, 25, that is bone chilling for May, so that's going to be a hard freeze warning, I think, for those areas we still may see getting issued, and a good real estate of area under a frost or freeze advisory. And look at this, just to the south we have flood watches and flood warnings from all the thunderstorms and severe weather that has occurred. And that's not the main thing, because we're still expecting an additional several inches of rain. So right now they're finally warm, they're drying out, it's sunny across Kansas, but that was from the previous wave. The rivers are already on the rise. You're gonna expect some more rivers to be on the rise. Look at this, some of these areas, 4+ inches of rain in the next couple of days. This is through Tuesday, and today's Sunday, so heavy rainfall is definitely expected. We have that another one of those systems occurring. And if you're wondering when, if you live in the Topeka, Wichita area, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. The western part, and then through about 5 p.m. it reaches Topeka. So fairly quick moving, definitely not a slow moving system, but very, very heavy rainfall. And you can see severe thunderstorms possible as well. Tornadoes possible, 75 miles per hour wind, large hail, and and there's different criteria for the other colors. And so there definitely will be flooding for those areas. And if you're in a flash flood warning, if you're by a river, then definitely, stay watchful, because this area is going to be filled with rain. There's definitely going to be tornadoes, severe weather warnings, tornado watches getting issued. So that would be interesting. Also, if you're still watching this and you'd like me to live stream maybe the severe weather, or live stream whenever consider leaving a comment. I may live stream, you know. I just may do so. I'll see, you know, because that'll be fun interacting with you guys. So if you want me to live stream, consider doing that, leaving a comment and talking about that. I want to quickly go over and show you what the rainfall will look like on the weather models. I don't remember. I told you this would not be a long video. It's at 5 minutes on here, a little bit over 5 minutes. So I will try keeping it under like 8. But we'll see that. Sorry about that. We'll see that the first system's pulling away, leaving cooler conditions across the east. But then we see that second system, so the cooler conditions don't last for long because a lot of warm air is pumped up, and this system just delivers potentially even more damaging severe weather. I mean, you can see some of those colors. That's more of some thunderstorms and very heavy rain. And that pushes through, you could see, into Illinois, Indiana, the east by Wednesday. And this system is very powerful, again, for a summer-spring system. It's very powerful, but it does fall apart. And we could see another one next Friday, next weekend. And active weather definitely continues. I mean, you could see storm after storm after storm. And then we could see they're even hinting at a tropical storm over here. But again, tropical season is starting, so we got to keep a watchful eye on for that. So that's basically it for today. I just wanted to quickly go over these watches to show you. An interesting thing is I could also point out that there is winter storm warnings across California. The Sierra Nevada, that's up to 14 inches in some areas. That's associated with another Pacific storm. Winter storm watches are up for Colorado, the mountains, the Rockies, and that's completely not uncommon to see snow at that time of the year. That's from the same system, but just a little couple days later. That's why it's still a watch, not a warning. And then we see a winter weather advisory for Yellowstone. If I click on some of these areas, I mean, they're going to be seeing snow like every day. Very chilly and cold pattern. Even though it is cold there, I mean, look at that, snow showers almost every day, and these temperatures are bone chilling cold. So yeah, I mean, it's definitely going to be chilly. So thank you guys so much for watching. Consider subscribing. Consider, you know, liking, whatever you want to do. And leave a nice comment. I'll see you guys in the next episode. See ya. Bye.